In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this really cool chimney roof inside of Revit. We're going to cover all of the steps, and most importantly, we're going to make it as a parametric roof that's going to adapt to all of the changes. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. As you can see, I have these four walls. They're basically going from level 1 up to level 3, and here we're going to be creating our chimney roof. So I actually want my chimney roof to go from level 2 to level 3. So for that, let's go here to roof by footprint. Then I'm going to pick level 2 as our roof level, or our lowest roof level, click yes, and then we can pick out a roof. I'm just simply going to be using this basic roof 1, and then I'm going to be using pick walls. So I'm going to hover over one of the walls, hit the tab key, and then it's going to select or highlight the entire chain of walls, and you can see that dashed line basically indicating the position of that roof. Now I'm going to just click to place that, and what you'll notice is basically it placed this on the inside edges of these walls. We don't want that. We want this to be on the outside, so let's then click here to flip this to the outside. Now, this being a chimney roof, it's going to be angled at two sides, and then two are just going to be straight walls. So what we'll do next is I'm just going to select a couple of these sides. So let's hit the escape key a couple of times, select a couple of these sides or edges, and then go to define slope and uncheck define slope on those. Then I'm just going to hit finish, and we're going to have this roof that looks, well, exactly like this. Okay, now we have to make some changes. So the first change that we're going to be making is just to attach the walls to this roof. So I'm just going to hover over one of these, hit the tab key once to highlight the entire chain of walls, click to select, and then go to attach top base. Make sure that top is selected here, and then let's click on that roof, and this is what we have. Then I'm going to hit the escape key a couple of times. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select this roof, then let's go to the properties and let's change the slope to 45 degrees, just like this. So we have this higher slope. Then to actually create the chimney opening, let's go up here, and in the constraints, we have the cutoff level option, and I'm just going to change the cutoff level from none to level 3, hit apply, and basically it's going to be cutting our roof at the level 3 height. See, just there. There we go. And then finally, one more thing that I like to do is I like to fix these edges of the roof. I don't like it looking like this, where we can see the face of the roof. So let's go to construction, find the rafter cut, and change it from plumb cut to two cut plumb, like this, hit apply. So what this does is basically it makes this cut straight, which just makes everything look a little bit better. Now, what's really amazing about using this approach that they have shown you, where you use that cutoff level, well, now we can use the level 3 in order to control the height and the size of this opening, basically. So if I come here and change this from 7,000 to 6,000 millimeters, as you can see, it's going to drop down, and then we can even move it manually. And as you can see, it can change basically the size or the opening of that roof, which is really, really cool. Okay, so having done this, a couple of more tips that I want to show you is when we switch this to realistic, and now we can see, of course, the materials and everything. What you'll notice is that the material will not be applied correctly here at the edge. This is a common issue with Revit. So if we want to fix this, we can just go here to modify, and then we can find the paint tool here. Here we go, paint. And then you can find this wood shake and just apply that material to that face there. and here, and there we go. I can just hit done. And then of course, you don't want to leave this as just an empty opening. So let's go to architecture and then let's create a roof. So I'm just going to switch to level 3, open that up. Then here, let's make this visible by going to view range, clicking here on edit, and let's just change the view depth just like this, zoom in, and then let's create another roof. I can use the same one, you can use a different one. I'm just going to uncheck define slope and use a simple rectangle. And then basically here, we just want it to fit into the size of this opening. You can leave it like this, or you can even lock it in place on all sides. That can even work as well. And then it's just going to be a bit more adaptive and it's going to follow the changes. So anyways, let's do this, hit finish. There we go. So we have that roof on top. You want to select it then, and now we want to move it down a little bit. So let's see, the thickness is 125. So let's give it a base offset of minus 125. There we go. So it's going to look like that. And then you can also go to modify and use join geometry, check on multiple join, select that roof, and then let's just join everything else to this little roof that we have created. And of course, we can fix these edges again by using the paint tool and applying the same material to these edges as well. Done. And then we can just, of course, add a window on top, which I think is going to be a great addition. So let's add this skylight in, select it, and we can open up level 3. And here we can just use these adaptive points in order to just extend the size of this window to kind of match the size of the opening, just like that. And there we go. Looks really, really good. And now let's try flexing it just one more time to see if it works. So yeah, as you can see, if we change the elevation, it is going to follow that change basically with the roof. However, you do then have to change the either the position of the window to make it centered, or you can go into level 3 and then just adapt the dimensions to that opening. So there we go. If you want to get access to this Revit project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find all of them, over 500 files, on my Patreon page. The link will be up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.